at the OR Tambo International Airport in South Africa. We are waiting for one of our elders that is coming from Florida. His name is Elder Reed Gabrielson. He's one of the brothers we fellowship with.
Okay.
So he's supposed to arrive this morning. Today is the 3rd of August. The plane has been delayed. It's coming to British Airways 55. So the plane will arrive at 08:19. We're excited. We have not seen him before. We only fellowship through live streaming. We communicate through WhatsApp and through the emails. And we exchange pictures. So it is our first time to meet in person. So we are very excited to see him.
Okay.
So you know, leave the US to come all the way to Africa.
Yeah, I mean that is something.
Well, I had a brother that had sent me a text about 2 or 3 weeks ago, and he said, "I'm really concerned that you're coming to Africa for a preacher."
Yes.
And I said, "Well, I said, you know, I said I can stream Africa from my own living room. I said, but yes. I can't shake somebody's hand from 8,500 miles away."
Yes.
And,
yes.
You know, exactly. And I didn't come here just for the preacher. I came here for all the people, not just the preacher. You know, so that's really a desire in my heart to come.
So now, as you are here, are you confused time-wise?
Well, I don't know. It's hard. I did get a little sleep on the plane, but you know, I kind of make an adjustment. Brother Larry is retired, so he's adjusted to the time.
Yes.
Because he goes to bed early and he gets up early. But see, I'm self-employed and I still work. So I have to make that adjustment on Saturday. Go to bed early on Saturday so that when the service comes on, I can have a reasonable amount of sleep so I can be refreshed when I get up. And then I just have to readjust myself on Sunday before I go back to work on Monday. So it's a little bit challenging to do that. It's a little challenging.
Yeah.
Let's give God a hand clap again. We are in the presence of the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It's a beautiful evening. Amen.
Amen.
See what the Lord has done.
Yes.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
So it's no longer many miles away across the Atlantic. We are together again.
Hallelujah.
Just praising our God. Amen. Amen and amen. So, Bazalwane, this message is real. Amen.
Amen.
This message is alive. Amen.
Amen.
It brings people together. Amen.
Amen.
So we thank the Lord. So we're going to start with our service. It's evening time. And then I'm just going to request that we all stand. And then we just sing a song, worshiping song. And then we're going to open the service with a prayer. And I'm going to be asking our elder, Ntate Skosana, to open the service with a prayer. Amen. Oh, Shaba Shwang, Hakisi, Iyakubo.
Heavenly Father, we'd like to thank you for being with him all the way, Father, from so many kilometers, which some of us cannot count, where you have to travel some few days. Heavenly Father, thank you for keeping him safe and here. We are gathered here, Lord, with our pastor and with your children, Lord Almighty, just to bring this atmosphere, Father, that we've been longing for. We've been praying, Lord Almighty, that you have mercy, protection, Lord, your hand, Lord, upon our brother.
Amen.
Now that is here, Father, may you also, Lord Almighty, be with us as we are going to have some few speeches and some few items, Father, through your mercy, Lord. Thank you, Father, for being with us and for making this meeting possible, Father. May you take control of all the situation, Father. Whenever we pray, Father, we know that there's always some spirits that will always try to follow us and trying to mess up everything. But Father, being a merciful God, you loved us before the foundation of the world. And you have given us power, Lord Almighty, to overcome them. You said you'll build your church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And even that this evening, Lord, that word is still standing. And that power, Lord Almighty, is still with your bride. And Father, gracious Lord, thank you for what you have done unto us. We pray, Lord Almighty, that you bless each and everybody that will stand here and render an item, and everybody that will give a speech here, Lord Almighty, through your mercy, Father, we commit all everything unto your hands, Lord. Thank you, Father, for the neighbors that have allowed us, Lord Almighty, to have just this little noise in worshiping thee, Lord Almighty. You bless them also, gracious Lord, in the precious name of my Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
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 Just turn to your neighbor and say, God bless you.
Amen.
Just mean it from the bottom of your heart. Just say, God bless you, my sister. God bless you, my brother. Hallelujah. Amen. Sister Mketu, I saw you. Hey, there's a song, it's in my heart. I was listening to it. It says, Sizoviswa Masinya Ezulwini Lapaya. Actually, the song says, we'll be summoned higher up very soon, up in heaven. Amen. I don't know. Sizoviswa Masinyana Ezulwini Lapaya. Sizoviswa Jesus, we need you.
Able to take their seats, they may have their seats. As I greet you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Can we just say hallelujah? Amen. Amen. We are blessed once more again to be in the house of the pastor.
Amen.
Hallelujah. To welcome our precious elder, Brother Reed Gabriel,
amen.
All the way from Florida,
amen.
In the USA.
Amen.
We looked forward for this particular day, and we are happy,
amen,
to see him.
Amen.
All the time, the pastor will just say shalom to him through live streaming. But today, it is no longer the word, but it's a reality.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. From my side, welcome to the pastor's house.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We also want to appreciate, I see Brother Stanley here behind the camera. My brother just, hallelujah, amen. I saw Brother Receiver also somewhere here. And we have our wonderful brother also behind the camera there, and Brother Given. So while we are using our phones to take the photos, can we also respect that we have official camera people that are here?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you.
Great tribulation. remain victorious when we call on Jesus the Christ. We'll lift you up. Jehovah is your name. We remain victorious when we call on Jesus the Christ.
God's only son, you are the King of who I am.
Hallelujah.
Every road I've traveled down before, you have walked before me. And you laid my life before your throne. I am looking for a day when I'll bow before you. Throw my crown at your feet. You are my King. You Lion of Judah, Seed of Abraham, the only one, God's only Son, you are the King of
sun, moon, and stars in there.
I would like to greet you all, saints, in the precious name of my Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I don't have my sin aids, but you said I should introduce and have a speech.
Yes, introduce the pastor's family and give a speech.
Okay. I would like to thank the Lord for giving us this opportunity.
Amen.
To have this a welcoming party for our brother here, Brother Reid. So, my name, Brother Reid, I'm Peter Skosali. I don't know whether you know me. Okay, I'm a deacon here in Mamelodi and an elder in Mamelodi. Mine, as requested by the MC, is just to introduce, as he said, the family of the pastor, Brother Reid. Firstly, we are here. This is the pastor's place. The pastor is the one that's sitting next to you. He is the one that will say a lot about you. Possibly, who was supposed to be the one. Is it not the pastor that's supposed to be introducing?
Yes, you will introduce.
Mm. Okay, fine. Mine is just to give a speech, little bit of speech. Thank you for traveling such a long distance, Brother Lee. And thank you, believers, for attending this mini welcome celebration. I first would like to introduce to you our pastor, even if you know him, just for the formality. Yeah, he's next to you, can shake his hand. Brother Ray, we have Sister Ngojima, the wife of our pastor. I will ask her to raise so that you could see her. Always, I don't know exactly who's the firstborn, Sharon or Tumelo. I always say Sharon. Are you the firstborn? Yeah. Okay, that's the firstborn. The pastor's firstborn. Just rise, my sister. Is Tumelo here? No, he's not in. Then comes Dokas. You need Dokas, just come closer so that Barry can see. That's Dokas. That is the first one. The second one is not in here. Then we had the last one is this son, Aquila. Can you rise? Grandchildren that are now, two of them are married, one is unmarried. So the eldest, that's the Sister Sharon's daughter, I don't know whether level's here. Oh, just come nearer, my sister. Closer here to the camera. Amen. I don't know whether the husband is here.
He's here. He's here.
Oh, yeah. He's very shy, but he must come.
Come with the baby, too.
And the second one is
Halaletang.
Halaletang. That's the second one. Where's the baby? Where's the baby? And where's the husband? Okay, the last one is Mohau. Come over here. Okay, Dokas, we've got also husband and family. I would like them to come over. Dorcas, come again with your husband and your children.
Husband, what was the phone for this boy?
Yeah, you will forgive me about the names. I always call it wrong. That is supposed to be
Lereku.
And the other one?
Kani.
Okay. Thank you very much. And also, the others are the relative of the pastor, that's Brother Dumelo. It's just rise a little bit, my brother. Pastor's elder son. And then we have our granny here. Granny, just rise up. That is Pastor Ngolima's sister. Her sister's wife. Am I right?
Yeah.
Yes.
In English.
Okay, otherwise, the others, we are all related to the pastor.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I'll have to introduce him.
For the foundation.
Yeah. Amen.
Okay, Brother Ray, concerning you, we're so grateful. How many kilometers
that's a good question you asked because I did stop and figure that out. And it's
13,700.
Oh, 13,700. Very close, Joseph.
Yeah.
13,700 kilometers.
Oh, yes.
And how many hours?
Well, I flew 22 hours, but that was because I had to go to different destinations to get here. I know when the pastor traveled and went over, he went from here straight over to Atlanta, and that was 16 hours, I think. But that was probably, it was a different airline. The airline I took, I had to go to London and then from London down to here, so it took a little bit longer to get here.
Thank you. Now, what happened here? Brother Reid, we didn't know him, but he knew us through live streaming, just a little bit. Oh, but you give your own speech. Let me take your speech. Let me not take your speech. But we Brother Reid, we didn't know you, but we knew you spiritually. You know, we are with you every Sunday. And we're with you also attending the church every Wednesday. So, but then we were together, our theophanies are together, our souls met. Now we are so grateful to see the body that is carrying your soul. And we see it now physically. We are so grateful to see him physically. Yesterday we were fellowshipping with the pastor. I said to the pastor, you know, Brother Ray reminds me of the Queen of Sheba, who traveled quite a long distance to see the king, King Solomon. So now, Brother Ray, you are a he, you are not a she. But let me make you a queen now.
Yes.
Which is the bride. So in my little speech, like the Queen of Sheba heard about Solomon. But do you know I'm like a bride to come and see the king. Now I'm not making the pastor God. I'm just making him a carrier of the word. That's the word that attracted him.
Yes.
There is no body that can travel such a long distance without a pulley within his heart. So there was a deep that was calling him to come and meet the carrier of the word, which is the bride meeting the bride.
Amen.
But there is a man behind the pulpit.
Yes.
that was dishing out that food. That's the one that attracted you. That's the one that pulls you.
Amen.
So now, Brother Ray can shame a lot of us here. Can shame a lot of us here. The way he is pulled and attracted by the wind.
Amen.
So we are so grateful, my brother, to set up an example. You belittled us in such a way that at times we fail God in traveling some few kilometers and going somewhere. So may the Lord greatly bless you.
Amen.
It's a lesson. You showed us a lesson. And then you follow the way the way it go.
Yeah.
And by the way, when the Queen of Sheba arrived there, and then the Bible said, I went to visit the Bible yesterday just to read about the Queen of Sheba, how she took it. It says that Solomon showed her all, everything, the order of the church, everything. And then he said, what you have shown me, it's not even the half of what they were telling me. I traveled all the way thinking that I was having only half of the thing. Now you have declared everything unto me. So we are so grateful, Brother Ray, with this few words. I would say, keep on keeping on.
Right.
May the Lord bless you all.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you, saints. We are going to invite our elder just to say a few words, if the pastor permits. We're going to sing a song, Brother Tsakane. I just want you to sing something special to invite our brother to come forth. He has a testimony that he was sharing with us, and I will also request him to share the testimony also. I'm sure the pastor will be delighted to hear that testimony. And we want to capture it on camera. It's a wonderful testimony.
Until the day.
Gracias.
There you go.
Well, I have to tell you that I'm pretty much overwhelmed here. I'm inclined to pinch myself and ask myself, am I really here or am I just but I'm very, very thankful to be here. Some things I was probably maybe going to share at another time, but I'll kind of just touch on a couple things here. And that is, one thing I did want to say is, it is a real sword, and I am a real person. Just in case you're wondering. So if you happen to shake hands with an imaginary, non-existent person, you just have to say, well, you know, maybe it was just in my mind, but it sure felt like a real hand to me. So, but I've traveled this great distance for one reason, and that is because you can't shake someone's hand from 13,700 kilometers away.
Okay.
A few weeks ago, I had a man who is a minister, and he had sent me a text, and he said, "I'm concerned that you're going to Africa for a preacher." And I thought, you know, that's kind of shallow, really. And I said, you know, I said, I can stream the services that I stream from my home. I said, but I can't shake somebody's hand from this greatness.
Amen.
And I want you to know, you here, and hopefully your entire assembly, that although I love this brother from having streamed the service, I didn't come here for just him, okay? I came here for everybody here because I recognize that each one of you, whether you're here that I have seen or whether somebody in the back of your congregation that I maybe have not met, that each one of you in your own way represent part of the body of Christ in a unique capacity that no one else can fill.
Amen.
Okay? And that is why I'm here. I'm here because I love you as a people, because I wanted to come here and see you, and so that's my reason for being here. I would mention to you that had it not been for Brother Larry Mims, I would not be here now. Because Brother Larry, as I was sharing earlier, Brother Larry heard your song, now it's slipping my mind.
My soul is in Christ.
My soul is in Christ. Thank you. I needed that. After all this travel, my mind's just here. My soul is in Christ. So Brother Mims heard that song, My Soul is in Christ, and he thought, I wonder if there is a church assembly or something associated with these people singing this song. So then he found out about your assembly. So that song was the spark that started the fire. And then after he found out about your assembly, then he shared it with me, and it turned into a bonfire. Because when I saw your assembly, I said, no, that's something. Because this is a very unusual assembly in the sense that to get to know you on the basis of you commenting, or you making mention of my comments on the stream, that's not normally done. That's not, you know, most people that stream a service, they stream it. If they make a comment, the comments are just, you know, passed on, and maybe somebody will notice them or whatever. But to have something brought up and really mentioned, that's quite unique in itself. I have been criticized for talking too much, and that's probably true. I could go into that, but I simply say it comes by me naturally. My mother was a very sociable kind of person. She could go to a grocery store and stand in a line to go to the checkout, speaking to saying you're a woman maybe she didn't know, and then next thing you know she'd start talking to her, and by the time she got ready to pay for her groceries, she might be passing recipes or saying, why don't you come over or something. She was just that kind of person.
Yeah.
And I grew up in a very safe community. We didn't have crime, we didn't have people robbing other people, we didn't have racial tensions, as you've had a lot of that in this country. I grew up in a racially tension-free environment, okay? I know that's hard to imagine or hard to believe, but I did. So, and for the most part, I didn't see any real racial tensions until I had gone into the military and I made friends with a black man, and then he got with some other friends of his that were other black friends of his, and then my friendship suddenly was no longer there. And it wasn't, I understand that's the way of the world, We realize that as Christians, we know we're brothers and sisters here. Amen. We love each other. We don't care what color we are. We just know that there's a spirit that we love and we want to be part of.
Amen.
Okay? So that is why I'm here. I could probably say a lot more, but it's late and I don't want to drag things out too much. But I want you to know that I am overwhelmed by just the greeting that I got at the airport. Mm. And the way I have been treated since I've been here is just beyond my capability to express my gratitude to you. And I really appreciate you all. And the love you have shown to me is just amazing. So God bless you all.
I don't know.
I think you're next.
That's me. Amen. Yeah, it's so wonderful.
Amen.
To meet my brother here, elder. You know, I always call him my elder, or elder in the church.
Yes.
Okay. And brother. Mims as well, and I believe one of the days God will make a way so that we can meet that soul.
Yes.
In the body.
Amen.
Amen. And myself, I'm quoting a bit since the Swaziland trip and so forth. I'm trying to block myself not to because. Okay, thank you. God bless you, brother. To me, it is like a dream, but then I said, no, it's real. I said, it's real.
Amen.
So, yeah, it is a great when we meet together, you know. It reminds me of a brother who is in Australia.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Is it Australia?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. There is this one who wanted to come here.
Yes.
Actually, he was saying, I want to go there and worship there in Mamelodi, this and that. And, but I don't know which one because you have another one who came here, you remember?
Yes.
And people, they misinterpreted his comments and so forth. I've got all of your comments, and the brother Mims as well. Yes, the man, my witness, this one with cell phone. I asked him to put them together. So all the comments, we've got them, and so to us they are spiritual.
Yes,
and so. Now I just want to say thank God for our brother is here, and well, you know, I phone brother, is it brother Pelly, you know, the Australian, my brother in Australia, he's actually a Congolese, but they're working in East. So when I phoned him, I said, brother, I believe that we met in before the foundation of the world. Yeah. So, what did he say? I said, we met before. And then he said, no, we were together.
Right.
Yeah, we didn't meet, we were together.
Yeah. Amen.
Like you say, we are together again. Sing it like me.
Just praising the Lord.
So, maybe I've taken a long key.
We are together.
Yes, that's
again.
It.
We are together again. Just praising the Lord.
Just praising the Lord.
We are together again.
Together again.
again. It's not our first time to meet.
Yes.
And then we met somewhere beyond it. Beyond the curtain of time. Yeah. And we are together again. And again, as Brother Branham says now, we are now going beyond the curtain of time. And again, we are going back.
Yes,
we are going back and so forth, but together. That's why when I heard the comments of our brothers and brother Mims, I knew that we were together.
Yes.
And that's why we are together.
Yes.
And we will be together.
Amen.
So God bless our brother and the others that have promised to come. We also, as we were in Congo, to meet the others there.
Yes.
And others in Uganda, they were calling and so forth. So we are just coming together now.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And Brother Branham calls it the last meeting.
Amen. Yes. Yes.
You know, the meeting of the souls that were together and are together again. So I also thank God for this opportunity.
Amen.
To greet my brother and together with you. Where's Brother Lisiba? Yeah. Oh, God bless you, my brother. And the crew, the camera crew, and everybody, Brother Mhuba, how are you, sir? God bless you all. And I think it's not that far. No, it is because of my, you know, throat here. But we are together again, and we are. God is going to do wonderful things for us while we are together with our brother here. You know, Satan was trying to say he doesn't exist. We knew that it is Satan. Yeah, Satan can tell the people that the Lord Jesus Christ doesn't exist. But we, who were in him and with him, we know him.
Amen.
Amen.
So God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Welcome. Boom.
Amen. God bless you. I want to thank you all for being here, for the support that you gave. Sister Dorcas, thank you. It's beautiful. Hallelujah. And all the brothers and sisters that assisted to make this function to be so beautiful, may the Lord richly bless you.
Amen.
And to the pastor's family, we want to say thank you.
Amen.
Pastor, thank you. Amen. The keyboard players, may the Lord richly bless you. We don't want to miss you on Sunday. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The pastor was talking about you yesterday.
Amen.
To say you played very well in Swaziland. So take your position, my brother.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I also want to say, Brother Mpo, may the Lord richly bless you.
Amen.
You know, yesterday the pastor was just saying, call him Mpo.
Yeah.
He will do something at the airport.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
right.
And he really played a major role, Pastor.
Amen.
When we arrived at the airport, the security wanted to stop us from taking pictures. We called Mpo, he spoke to them. Because Mpo works at the airport, he went an extra mile to go beyond the curtain.
Yeah.
to find our brother.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
So it was very special because with us, we wait on the other side.
Yeah.
So Mpo was able to go beyond.
Yeah.
And told us that the brother has arrived.
Amen.
And also, we want to say we loved your character. You see, we caught you by surprise. We didn't say we wanna wait at the airport with the brothers and sisters, but when you saw us, you were so excited and you really enjoyed the welcome, and we just loved that. You took time, you were tired, you took pictures with us and the video. It was very, very special. May the Lord richly bless you. Amen.
I just wanted to say one thing briefly. When I came down the walkway and I see this sign that says Reed Gabrielson, and I look and I say, wait a minute, I don't know who that man is. He sent me three pictures, one of the pastor and one of himself, and the other one was an elder. Was it not an elder?
The other brother, I think it was.
Okay. So, and I'm saying, I don't know about this. So I'm thinking, maybe I should get my phone out and I'll make sure. So then he gets me all past, and then he's taking me all past everybody else and all the way to the front. I'm thinking, wow, what's going on? Really unusual, you know. And then I find out that he's actually with security, and okay, I got it. But I was nervous because I've never been in this country and I don't know anybody here other than those of you, you know. So, but I thank you all for what you meant.
We are going to sing that special song. I believe you are the composer.
No, it's Mthokozisi.
It's Mthokozisi.
Yes.
But you can assist us with that song.
Yes, yes.
Yes, then we invite Babe Kabazela just to say a word of prayer. And after, I believe they also prepared something for dinner. Just say a word of prayer. Then thereafter, our brothers will just play something soft, then they will make a way for the elders and the pastor to go to a special room upstairs, and the rest of us we will remain in here. We will be guided by the family what will be the next step. May the Lord richly bless you. Amen.
My soul is worth more than 10,000 worlds that lame may walk, that blind may see, but no greater miracle than to save my soul. He knew me then.
He knew yeah.
Greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'm so happy. You don't know why I'm so happy. But there was a secret that I did find there from Brother Ray there. When I came there, he just told me, who am I? I was so surprised. So, and then Omar has given me a has changed my name.
Oh my!
You know Omangit. So when I come there, and then Brother Ray said, Baba Makiza. I was so shocked.
He's in so bad.
He's confirming.
Yeah, I did, because, you know, you have a hard time with English names. We have a hard time with African names. Yeah. I did catch his last name. So I said, when I get a chance, I'm going to introduce myself to him and say his name.
Amen. We are so happy. Can we close our eyes and pray? Baba wethu, usezulwini, uNkulunkulu namandla wonke. Kuhlala kuyintokozo ngaso sonke isikhathi ukuba sebukhoneni bakho uNkulunkulu engcwele. Nkosi uDavid uthi ngajabula lapho bethi kimi masiye endlini kaJehova. Nkulunkulu olungileyo, this meeting is the last meeting. Nkulunkulu olungileyo, there's no meeting like this. Nkulunkulu olungileyo eke yaba khona. Nkosi, we are so happy and we can see soon and very soon we are going home. Umfundisi, there was a song that liked to sing sometimes ago. It ntanda uqala la. Nkulunkulu olungileyo, we are starting here to praise you. Siyabonga Nkosi, usihlanganisile ngale ndlela osihlanganise ngayo Nkosi. Some believers, Nkulunkulu olungileyo, they are longing to be here, but because of the distance, Nkulunkulu olungileyo, they couldn't manage. Father God, we are so happy with our brother here. May you bless his family at home. May you bless the church at home. May you bless him, Father God, while we are here. Baba, sisazo drive us here in the ones that you can emakaya. Nkosi, may you take control, Nkulunkulu engcwele, on those cars. Baba, on the roads, Nkosi. There are so many accidents esibonayo. There are so many crooks Nkosi abathathelwe izimoto ngezibhamu. But uNkulunkulu ulungileyo to your children. That will never happen.
Yes.
We pray, dear Lord, may you come down, Nkosi, and bless our pastor, uNkulunkulu ulungileyo, for the heart omnikeze yona and the discernment Nkosi omnikeze yona.
Yes.
We are so happy, Father, to serve under his ministry. Yeah, that you
exactly.
Give him, Father God. There's no other place that we can see that is better than this, Father God.
Yes.
We pray, dear Lord, may you come down and take control in our soul. Bless everybody who is here in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.